Hello guys, today I'll be teaching you how to use this IVA PRO26DX digital speaker processor. So let's assume we have two full range speaker and two subwoofers. So we'll be setting up the crosspoint and whatever other setting we need to do. So first thing, I'm going to set output 1 as my first subwoofer. So I just to enter to the setting of the output 1, I'm pressing the mute, press and hold. Okay, now we change to all is the output 1, phase, delay, the crosspoint, EQ, compressor, the source. You can see it's from input A. And then do we want to link the channels? And copy the other channels. Okay, first, let's say you want to set my subwoofers is from, let's say 30 hertz to 80 hertz. So I set my high pass to 30 hertz. So I press cursor to switch from this to this. Then I move to 30 hertz. Okay, I have it. Then maybe I change this to Butterworth 48. Yes, we have it, Butterworth the filter type. And then next we set the low pass, which is 80 hertz. Okay, we move from here, go down here. Yes, we have 80 hertz. Maybe we use the filter 24 Butterworth. Yes, we have it. So we successfully set the crossover point from 30 hertz to 80 hertz for channel 1. Let's say we need to copy the similar setting from 1 to, let's say, output 3. I just press next, 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 next. I just make sure my output 1, copy 2, output 3. I just press this, enter. It will ask you, sure, yes or no. Just choose yes, enter again. Then you are successfully copying output 1 to 3. Okay. So if you want to set your full range starting from maybe 80 hertz to 20 kilohertz, so we just press and hold output 2. So next page, next page, next page, next page. So we have it high pass. So we start from 80 hertz. Yes, we have it. 2. Yeah, I forgot. 80 hertz. We are using 24 Butterworth. And then the low filter, I can set to 20 kilohertz. Okay. It is around here. Maybe for 36 Butterworth, up to you what kind of filter you want. There you have it. The full range crosspoint for output 2 is set. If you want to copy this to number 4, then you just press next, 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 H9, copy 2, output 4. Yes, yes, it's done. Okay, so we need to do some equalization. Let's say we want to boost 60 hertz to the subwoofers. So we go back to the output 1. Okay. So page 5, EQ. So we have 7 band EQ here. We can set whatever setting you want. Then on and off it. You need to on it to make sure it's working. Off it, it's not working. Okay, we leave it on. Then we have EQ type, low shelf 2, which is the 12 octave, the 6 octave. And then we have the high shelf 1, high shelf 2. So you can choose the type of filter you want. And let's say we are going to set the 60 hertz. So we have it, we change to 60 hertz. Yes, we have it. Maybe we want to for 60Hz, we are going to put a plus 6 dB. Okay, we have it. Then this is the octave. How fat or thin is the filters? So it depends on what number you want. Okay, then that's all. So if you want to set the second filters, just press back, go back to here, change to number 2, then you're good to go to set your second filters. For example, maybe 97. Okay, you are going to reduce 3 dB and maybe 0.1 octave. Okay, after you are doing this, so you sometimes you may need to set a delay because of the phase alignment issue. So here you can put your delay to your subwoofers, so you can see how many milliseconds. It will automatically convert to meters and feet. So if you need to delay 1 meter, so we just change to 1 meter. Yep, it's done. And we have a phase. If you need to change the phase, you just change the phase. We leave it back to 0. Again, sometimes you need to balance the gain between the full range and subwoofers, so you can plus minus here. It's up to your own taste. And then finally, you need to set your limiters. So we are going to H6, so you have to make sure it's on. This is the hard knee, soft knee. So normally we are using the hard knee for the limiter part. Then what is the threshold? This is the ratio for limiter. Normally I set to 128, and the attack time maybe we set to 10 milliseconds. How fast this limiter works, the release time, how long the limiter will release back to normal. So now it's done, the settings. So for whatever you have done, you need to save it. So it's very simple. To save the setting you have done, we just press this save button. So you have go to store user program. So now let's go, we look for empty memory. Yes, number 4, we have an empty memory. So to rename the thing, we just press the cursor, go down. So you are free to put your own name. So let's say we put a memory, for example. I press this again, save. Yes, press again. Okay, now it's safe. So just if I want to recall back, press recall, go to setting number 4. Yeah, you can see it, your memory. So you did all your settings, you save it. But unfortunately, some people will disturb your thing. So there's a locking system which you can input some password and then you lock the thing, and others people will not able to access or change anything. So we press this button, press and hold. Okay, then go to page 7. So from here, we can change what type of lock we have. So this, we protect the processor from other people to change the setting. So this, we protect people from change and view. They cannot even view the settings. Here, we cannot even mute the thing, the mute button. And then everything, you cannot do anything with the thing without a password. So for example, I'm going to lock this thing, everything. So I press this cursor button to go down. And I put a password, maybe 1, next, 2, three, okay, let's enter. Yes, so now it's successfully locked. So I'm going to do something, press and hold. Nope. You can see from here, so I try to access anything. Okay, press lock. I cannot mute the thing. Okay. So I need to unlock. I cannot press and hold here, try to access the thing, it's unlocked. Press and hold again, it's unlocked. Everything is locked.